So now we'll look at a slightly better idea. And this was actually what was done by early versions of Unix. So the idea was to store for each user the result of encrypting using the user's password as the key, the value 0. So this means there's no key to keep secret on the server. Someone who compromises the password file, well, they know that the value being encrypted is 0, but would need to test possible passwords to find the one that matches. And to make this harder, you wouldn't just run encryption once, you would run it many times. If you encrypt twice, well, this doubles the work to check a password. It also doubles the attacker's work for each password to guess. Since the attacker has to guess many more passwords than just the one that was entered, this scales the attacker's work more than it scales the checking work. And the way this worked in Unix, it was doing this 25 times. So the value that was stored for each user was the result of encrypting using the password as the key, using 0 as the initial value, but looping it around 25 times. There's some problems with the way this was done in early Unix systems. The encryption function was DES, the data encryption standard, which used 56-bit keys. And the key was generated from the password by just cutting it off. Take the first 56 bits. So with the 56-bit key, the first 56 bits of the user's password are used. If this was encoded as 7-bit ASCII, that was only 8 letters. It was actually a little bit less than that because DES placed some restrictions on the key structure. So if users selected their passwords using only the uppercase, lowercase, and digits, this corresponds to 62 possibilities. Most users would not pick uniformly from those 62 possible characters. But if they did, there are 62 to the 8 possible passwords. This is less than 2 to the 48. For someone with modern computing resources, doing a search on a space like this is very feasible. The reality is even worse than this, that a motivated attacker can pre-compute a dictionary, pre-compute this value for a set of common words W, store those pre-computed values, and then every new password file that's compromised, check all the passwords against this list, and have a good likelihood of finding some accounts that can be broken into. So how can we make dictionary attacks harder? Well, one idea would be to train users to pick better passwords. Users are pretty hard to train. This usually means coerce instead. Force users to pick a password that satisfies some properties. It could be a minimal length, a mix of upper and lowercase letters and special characters. Many websites do this. It usually just leads to annoyance and doesn't necessarily lead to better passwords. You can certainly come up with bad passwords that satisfy any set of rules that someone forces you to use. So another solution would be to protect the encrypted passwords to make sure that an attacker or an insider can't get access to them. This would certainly help, would prevent the dictionary attack because they wouldn't have access to the encrypted passwords. They could still try a small number through the login interface. If the passwords are bad enough, well, the dictionary attacker will still succeed, but only breaking a small number of accounts. The third approach is to add salt. This is the one I'll talk about next.